Roberto Trevino.
First of all, thank you very much for doing this. Appreciate it. I know you're incredibly busy right now. You got the budget. You got all kinds of stuff you're working on. The Alamo.
Yeah.
Where are you in the Alamo master plan right now? I've noticed a few things on the website and then the Facebook page. There's a new rendering. What does it all mean? Where are you?
Well, we're kind of waiting for the Texas Historical Commission to make a ruling on the permit to relocate the cenotaph. And so what people don't know is that we actually submitted the permit request last year in December of 2019. All this time. And so there is currently, and I say currently because we, you know, this is what's happened. And we had one in January, then in February, and then they scheduled it for March. And, you know, April, May, and June. And next thing we know, we have one scheduled for September 22nd. You know, obviously we hope that everything goes well. but that's what's created a lot of the delay. I think people think that it's the pandemic, but it's not. The construction can go on. What we know is that the battle is a significant event, and it becomes the portal by which we can tell a lot of this compelling history. What we also know is the story that has been well known, well recognized for all these years is a mythology. It's wrong. It's bunk. San Antonians don't want that. San Antonians don't want to tell that. It perpetuates a lie. It perpetuates. Moving the cenotaph, and people will ask, well, why relocate the cenotaph? The cenotaph, done by Coppini, is seen as an artistic, important monument to some. The issue as we see it is that it sits in the middle of the historic mission footprint, San Antonio de Valero, or the nickname as we know it, the Alamo. It represents a very small slice of that history and a very narrow view of that, by the way. So if we are truly going to tell a complete story, if we are going to tell a story that unifies and heals a city, the cenotaph being in the middle of the site where you're going to be telling all these stories simply has to be relocated about 5 the cenotaph.
What do you tell those people who say it's a grave marker, it's a sacred item, and it shouldn't be moved?
It is not the site or a grave marker in any way. In fact, cenotaph means empty tomb.
Did you think it would be this tough to do this? I mean, it was years ago when the committees came up with, I think it was six items of what you wanted to do, and the number six was to renovate and relocate the cenotaph. I mean, it was right out there at the beginning.
It was, and it was unanimously approved, right? So the entire Citizens Advisory Committee, from the get-go, all agreed that in order to tell that story, we have to relocate the cenotaph. Yes.
Some of the concerns that some of the things that stuck out to me is going to be the grave sites. It's always going to be first and foremost what I
think. The other issue that I had was on one of the slides that you had, and it has to do with the cenotaph. And the location of the cenotaph in front of the Minger, one of the slides where you had all of this happened, and this happened, and this happened, and this happened. The cenotaph is located right where you say the Mexican soldiers were. And if you'll remember that the cenotaph is a tombstone.
That's right.
It's a headstone. great-great-grandfather's memorial, you know, and so it's important. I don't think we want to put it right where the Mexican soldiers were. I think that sends the wrong message.
It was no debate.
And now there are some who say, well, if you even try to move it, it's going to crumble.
The concrete and the marbles is a good mix. It was the ties that creates the bigger issue. We have, in fact, the mason that will be working on it is a multi-generational mason from San Antonio, a well-respected mason all over Texas for his knowledge, and is going to be working on the cenotaph. We even had a meeting with some of our critics to show them. I wanted to introduce them to the contractors and the mason and to let them know, like, ask all the questions you want, and you can see that these are the guys that know how it's done. And I will tell you that they left there impressed. They
it falls to you to explain all this in the middle of a pandemic and in the middle of this really emotional debate, which also turned political at the state level.
Well, you know, it's interesting. About 5 weeks ago, that was all the topic, as well as, you know, senators thought the number one issue was going to be redistricting when we get back and all that. Well, our world's changed, but our history hasn't changed, our heritage hasn't changed. The Alamo hasn't changed. And what I said, it's been since the primary, seems like a year ago, but I guess 5 weeks now, 6 weeks. On March 3rd, the people of Texas spoke loudly. I think it was 97%, said, do not tear down our monuments and do not move the cenotaph. And the last thing that anyone over at the Alamo should be doing, the land commission, story to be told. I want the story to be told of the Alamo, not the whole history of the mission. We have the mission trail for that. And the other thing that people said, we want a world-class visitor center that tells that story and that kids can learn from, interactive, so we can educate the, you know, the next generation of people about our history. So word to Doug down there, who's running the Alamo, and the Land Commission. Don't move that cenotaph.
Yeah, I think this is the biggest difference. So we've done so much work here in San Antonio. We had over 200 public meetings, countless private meetings. We had many citizens advisory committee meetings, meetings with the management committee almost every other week. There's just been a lot of work to get us to this point. As I mentioned, the last step in this is the Texas Historic Commission. And so in understanding how important it is to move the cenotaph, it's really tied back to our lease agreement with the state of Texas. So we do have a 99-year lease agreement with the state of Texas for the historic mission footprint.
The city owns the plaza.
The city. So, yeah, people need to understand that the reason the city's playing a role in this, or gets to play a role, is because the site has been bifurcated for so many years. In fact, because nobody really knew what the Alamo was, they'll show you a picture of a church or a building, right? But we like to say that the Alamo is not a building; it's a place. And so, a lot of it, where the city and roads and infrastructure have grown on top of it and around it. And so, the real important issue with all of that is that we tied everything that we worked hard for in the master plan to the lease, to say we are willing to lease this property, at least the mission footprint that the city owns, to the state of Texas, under the condition that it's following everything we've all agreed on. Everything the City Council agreed on, the Citizens Advisory Committee agreed on, our Historic Design Review Commission agreed on, Planning Commission agreed on, everything that we've presented. As I mentioned, the last step in this is the Texas Historic Commission.